So hi there, and welcome to this week's video. My name is Charles, and this week, what I'm going to be doing is taking you back down to my local woodland and doing a little bit more macro photography. But the plan is to do something slightly different to last time. This week, I've actually brought my focusing rail with me, and I want to run you through a couple of different ways that you can focus stack your photographs. So I'm going to demonstrate how to use a focusing rail, and I'm also going to demonstrate how you can use the inbuilt function of your camera to achieve a similar result. So anyway, that's enough talking. Let's crack straight on and go get some shots. And we've got quite a lot of new growth coming through, but we've also got some lovely texture from the dead ferns and bracken that were left over from last year. So hopefully we're going to be able to see some really nice textures and patterns that we're going to be able to photograph today. Things that make a really good subject for focus stacking. Walking around the woodlands for a little while, and I think I've finally found my first composition. I don't know why, I've been struggling to find exactly what I wanted to photograph. Maybe it's because I'd got something in my mind that I wanted to try and capture, and I've just not quite found it. But anyway, I think we're just about there. So what I found is a fallen tree, and it's still got some of the pine cones attached to it in a bit of a cluster. So what I'm going to do, I am going to set up my gear now and run you through how you could focus stack this image using a focusing rail. So, that's enough talk, let's just get set up and take the shot. Camera set up now on our focusing rail, but as you can see, it's sort of nowhere near the subject. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my multi-angled column just to get in much closer to the subject, and then just set up the shot. So bear with me for two ticks, and I will show you when I'm ready to take the shot. Got my focusing rail all set up just as I want it. I'm coming in nice and close to my subject, and I've got a really nice angle in on those pine cones that are just hanging from the branch. So the next thing to do is to show you how the focusing rail can be adjusted in the left and the right and forwards and backwards, just so you can get that perfect focus. Before we get started, we just need to make sure our camera's turned into manual focus mode and turn off any image stabilization. So the first thing I'm going to do is adjust the left and right just so I can get this lined up exactly as I want. So I'm going to turn on my screen. There we go. Oops. And then on the focusing rail, we've got two different dials. We've got one that will move it left and right, and we've got another one that will move it forwards and backwards. So the first thing we want to do, so now let's adjust it left and right just so we can get the perfect angle on this shot. So by twisting it in just really small movements, you're going to adjust the position of the camera just so you can get it spot on. So I'm going to try and get mine fairly centrally aligned. I think that's pretty much how I want it. So the next thing we can do, we can use the second dial to move it forwards and backwards. So now you can move forwards through the plane of focus, taking shots as you go. And this way, you'll get a pin sharp image for as far as you take the shots. So I'm going to take this back now, ready to take my first shot. So what I'm also using is focus peaking so that I can see when the area is perfectly in focus. Something else you can do is zoom in. So I've zoomed in to 100% and now I'm just going to really slowly fine tune my focus as I move in. There we go. And now, as you can see, the first elements are really finely into focus. And you can see from the focus peaking, if I zoom back out, you can see from the focus peaking that we've got a really nice focus on the first part of the image. So essentially what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a shot. I'm using my shutter release cable to help reduce any vibrations. Then I will adjust my focus ever so slightly by using the focusing rail to bring my camera ever so slightly closer to the subject. So let's take our first shot. And we adjust the focusing rail by a small amount using the focus peaking just to make sure you can see that you're getting a nice overlap on the focused area. And we now essentially repeat this process until you're happy you've got enough shots of the subject to get a beautifully sharp image across the field. So there we have it. I've now taken my first shot where we've focus stacked the image using a focusing rail, stacking several of these shots together. If the image is any good, I'm going to put it up on screen now. Next thing we need to do is go out and try and find another composition, and I'll show you how you can use the camera's inbuilt functions to achieve a very similar result. So let's get moving and go and find another shot to take. So I've stopped here because I've just found some really nice fresh growth that's just started to shoot up out of the ground. These trees here. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to set up my shot so that we can take a photograph using the focus stacking features of the camera. So I'm going to set up now and I'll show you when the shot is ready to take how you can do focus stacking with the inbuilt features. I'm going to be showing this on a Nikon camera, but most manufacturers will have something similar. So let's get straight onto it. So I've got my shot set up now, and the first thing I need to do is get focus on the nearest object. Now, If I was using a focusing rail, I could simply dial those dials to bring the camera backwards and forwards until my focus was spot on. But as I don't have that here, I'm going to need to just really finely tune it with my tripod. So I'm going to gently move my tripod until I get to the first part of the image that I want to get in focus. If in doubt, I'd suggest you take it ever so slightly past the object, almost so it's going out of focus, and then that way, when your camera takes its series of shots, its first shot should hit when it gets on into the focus range. Focus shift does require you to have your autofocus switched on, but we're going to leave the image stabilization off. So now we have our composition, I'm going to go into the menu of my camera. I'm going to go into focus shift shooting, and as you can see here, I've got my number of shots set to 50, and I've got silent photography on, because this can help reduce camera shake from the shutter going, but you can turn that on or off depending on your preference. But I'm going to leave it on for this, for the moment. So I'm now going to go leave that at 50 shots. I think 50 is going to be enough to get as much of the image in focus as I want. Now the focus step width, if you're shooting close up, you want to be nearer the narrow end of the scale. If you are shooting more of a landscape, you would go to the wider end of the scale. And basically that means at the narrow end, all the shots are going to be closer together. At the wider end, the images, the focus areas are going to be further apart. I've got mine set to 3. I find that's a pretty good compromise between the number of shots you have to take and making sure everything is in focus. So now let's just wait for the wind to die down and then we'll take our shot. And there we have it, we've now taken our stack of images. If we scroll through those, you can see a little bit of movement, but hopefully the focus stacking software will be able to sort that out. So there we go, a little introduction into how to focus stack either using a focusing rail or using the inbuilt functions of your camera. There's sort of positives and negatives to each method. So for example, one of the positives of using a focusing rail is the fact that you can really fine tune that focus and you get much more manual control over the focus shift that you want to achieve. But of course you do have to carry out extra equipment and that all takes up room in your bag and there's extra weight to carry. So if you want to travel light, then using the focus shift settings in your camera can be a really good way of getting a much quicker and easier result, but without the fine tuning and manual process behind it. As to some, that could be a positive, to some people that's going to be a negative. You know, so the choice is yours. Why don't you let me know in the comments below which process you prefer? Do you prefer to either use a focusing rail, or do you prefer to use the inbuilt functions of the camera and travel lighter? I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did enjoy it, please consider giving it a big thumbs up. That would really help me out. And until next time, take care and goodbye.